Hi, it's Kevin Bacon again. This is a long overdue video, and it's a rant. It's a rant about online bullying. And it goes on our YouTube channels. It goes on our games. It goes on all kinds of social media. And it's really very simple why it goes on. It goes on because people are anonymous. You can't reach out to them. And they will say things that they might normally never say to anybody to their face. But on the other side of this, in a lot of cases, they don't know what your face looks like, or they don't know anything about the person. So I play a game on Xbox that is a war game. And it's fun for me because I can enjoy it with family members all over the United States. In fact, probably anybody all over the world. But I'm not very good at it. Nor will I likely ever be good at it because these old hands just don't move very fast anymore. And I've had cataract surgery and my eyes don't track just perfectly anymore. There's just all kinds of things that interfere with my coordination. And, my neck bothers me from the surgery and other things of this nature that just makes it, and quite frankly, I don't care that much. I mean, I'm working towards some goals because it's fun. When it ceases to be fun, I'll probably quit doing it. But I listen to comments sometimes from other people and how they scream and holler at us for our ability or inability. And what I just really want to ask them is if their parents really loved them when they were growing up, and I'm sorry for them if they didn't, but they shouldn't take it out on everybody else. And the other thing is, perhaps they're hollering at somebody that's in a wheelchair with muscular dystrophy and this is all they can do because they got one hand left or something on that order. You just do not know who's on the other side of that you're screaming at. Perhaps you're playing with someone who has been one of my buddies that got shot and he doesn't have all his mental faculties anymore. And so, you just screamed and hollered at somebody who's mentally disabled. And so, it's just a sad shame. It's a sad shame that our world, and most cases these people are in our nation, have got to the point where they feel that they can holler and scream and all that other kind of stuff. Now, bring it on, because I don't care. This skin is leather. It doesn't matter to me. It's like water off a duck's back. I know who I am and what I'm doing and what my capabilities are and are not. And quite frankly, your opinion doesn't mean that much to me. And this is what I hope for all of you out there that have been or are bullied, is that you reach a point where you can become Teflon and nothing sticks. And once you reach that point where nothing sticks, you'll have a much better day. You'll have a much better day. Anyway, I refuse to put anybody down like that. I just refuse. It doesn't matter if I know who they are or not. I'm not going to do it. I've been through the bullying process, and I refuse to be the bully. Now, have I been in the past, in my military times and other things, could someone have considered me a bully? I suppose that's entirely possible. Have I done it later in life because it's become a habit? Yeah, it's possible. But I urge myself on a regular basis not to do that. And so that's where it is. Now, how do we stop it? I don't know. It's been going on for centuries. It'll probably continue to go on for centuries. You can have all the school programs you want, and they're probably not going to help. Because there are some people that are just going to be bullies. Unfortunately, they work their way up the ladder in corporations and become corporate executive bullies. And I have run into that in my retail business when I was working for a large corporation. I heard many corporate executive bullies and how they talked to people, and they were nasty. And quite frankly, if they spoke that way to my face, I probably would have gone to jail. And they probably would have gone to the dentist, if you catch my drift. But and upon occasion when I heard them talking to somebody else, I have to step in the way. Because they have no business speaking to anyone like that. Just because someone has given them a position of authority doesn't mean they need to be nasty. Walmart allegedly and I hate to, you know, bring up a particular, but allegedly is closing a whole bunch of stores down because they're having labor problems in those stores. That's bullying. It is. It's been going on in this nation for many, many years. It took unions to break some of that down, but these corporations will continue to do it as often as and as regularly as they can so that they can drive the wages down and increase their profits. And of course, the top people are making billions of dollars a day, and at a point where, you know, how much is enough? How much is enough? How much do you have to steal from your workers until you're happy? How much of someone's happiness do you have to steal by being nasty to make yourself happy? And I guess if you know, if that's the only thing you got going in your life is screaming at people here on these games and on YouTubes and stuff, hey, I really have to feel sorry for you. I do. And I really wish your parents had loved you more, because I'm sure that, you know, psychiatrists would say that's the root of it, that your parents just didn't love you enough. Anyway, that's my rant. Ken Bacon. Bye for now.